Fitness Academy, and today we will read the 6th chapter of class 7, A Hero, written by R.K. Narayan. Okay, we have to know something about R.K. Narayan. R.K. Narayan is an Indian English writer. It means he is from India and writes in English. Okay. And one of the famous story written by R.K. Narayan is A Hero. This story points out to how to make a dull boy into a brave boy. And that's, we all know, if we want to do something good, then we must have to pay or work hard for it. Similarly, in this story, his father, Swamis, we will go through the boy name. We will see what's the name, Swami. Okay, how Swami changed into a brave boy due to the efforts of his father. Before that, let's have the word stop of this chapter. Okay, see, first, prosperity. Prosperity means success. And fame. Fame means reputations. Okay? Reputations, you know, name, fame. Okay. Peri. Peri means risk, danger. Port means gallery. Sternly, severely, hardly. And groan. Groan means moan, unhappy. Pamper. Pamper means spoil, indulge. Encased. Hereafter. Henceforth. Henceforward. Tumbling, breakdown, and burglar, burglar means criminal. Okay, and there are number of word meanings. You have to write, find out, and then write out. Okay, let us read the chapter blank by blank. See, A Hero, introduction. Have you ever heard the proverbs, fortune favors the brave? Have you heard fortune favors the brave? Fortune favors the brave. Fortune favors the brave. Fortune favors the brave. It means भाग्य भी उसी के साथ देती है जो brave है, जो बहादुर है. जो बहादुरी नहीं है उसको भाग्य भी साथ में. इट मीन्स इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टेक द एडवांटेज ऑफ योर लक यू मस्ट हैव टू बी ब्रेव. ओके, डू यू नो द मीनिंग? फॉर्चून इन द ब्रॉड सेंस इज नॉट मेयर मनी. फॉर्चून डजंट मीन्स ओनली मनी. इट कैन बी प्रोस्पेरिटी, सक्सेस, फेम और एनीथिंग. देर आर मेनी सिचुएशन इन लाइफ दैट नीड लक. ओके, नंबर ऑफ थिंग्स यू थिंक्स, if I have bad luck, I have lost the match. It is not the fact. The fact is that you have not worked properly and there is something lackage in your work. We should always keep a hope that something lucky will happen in time to peril and distress. It means we must have to be hopeful while we are facing a danger or problematic things. We don't have to lose our hope. If we lose our hope, it means we have lost everything. Clearly, so dears, if we lose heart, we are unknowingly blocking fortune out. Only bold people can have success to access to fortune. Access to fortune means to get fortune. It means if you are bold enough, then you have favor of luck. If you are not bold enough, then the luck will not favor you. So, my dears, the introduction tells us that fortune favors the brave. If you want to have the advantage of luck, then you must have to work hard. After that, the luck will help you. Luck helps only those who help themselves. Clear? Oh, now is read the poem. Read the chapter. Read and enjoy the story. Father was sitting under the hall lamp and reading the newspaper. He looked over the newspaper and said, "Swami, listen to this. News has been received about the bravery of a village lad. Lad means boy, who a small boy. Lad who was returning home by the jungle path. While he was in middle of the jungle, he came face to face with a tiger. The newspaper gave a detailed account of the boy's fight with the tiger. He also described how the boy flew up a tree where he stayed half a day. At last, some people came that way, killed and the tiger." It means the father, Swami's boy's name is Father. He is very small and his father is reading a newspaper, news in the paper that a boy, how a boy, a small boy fought with the tiger in the middle of the jungle. Okay, see. After reading it through, father looked at Swami fixedly and asked, "What do you see to that?" "I think he must have been a very strong and grown up person." "Not a boy at all," said Swami. "How could a boy fight a tiger?" Then after his father asked to Swami, and Swami replied that, "I think he is not a small child, he must be a grown up person." It means adult person. How a small boy could fight a tiger? "You think you know better than the newspaper," said the father crossly. "A man may have the strength of an elephant and yet be a coward. Another may be a mere skeleton, but if he has real courage, he can do anything." It means his father is telling him that it means the newspaper, the report of the newspaper is wrong. His father asked, "If a person have power of elephant and if he is not have courage, that is useless. And if a person is a skeleton, it means thin, and if he has courage, then he can do anything." It means it is the matter of courage. If you want to do even the hardest things, you must have the courage. And it is the courage that will create the difference. Okay? Courage is everything. Strength and age don't matter much. "How can that be?" said Swami. "Suppose I had a lot of courage, but what could I do if a tiger attacked me?" Then Swami asked his father, I don't think so. "Can you prove you have courage?" said father with a scowl. "Let me see if you can sleep alone tonight in my office." Father said, "Can you prove you have courage? You can sleep alone in my office." Swami had always slept beside his granny in the park. The two always had their beds side by side. Any change in this arrangement kept him trembling and awake all the night. It means Swami is habituated to sleep beside his granny. It means Dadi. He hoped at first that father was only joking. He tried to change the topic by saying, "Father, our captain says we shall have some elders also in our cricket club. He had asked me to tell you. We will see about that later," father cut in. "Hereafter, you must sleep alone. Don't change the topic. Come on the topic. Can you sleep alone in my office?" And Swami is try to change the topic. From the first of the next month, "I will sleep alone," Swami said very humbly, trying to please father. "No, you must do it right from today," father said sternly. Sternly means severely, strictly. "Sleeping beside granny or mother like a boy is disgraceful. You are now in the fifth standard and I don't like the way you are being brought up." You are in 5th standard. Don't wait for the first date of the next month. Right from today, you have to sleep. Father lifted the newspaper to his face and started reading it again. Swami rose quietly from his place and tiptoed to his bed in the park. Granny was sitting up in her bed and she said, "Boy, are you already feeling sleepy today?" Don't you want to hear a story? That day, Swami wants to sleep early, but his granny told him, "You don't want to listen the story?" Swami made no reply. He threw himself on the bed and pulled the blanket over his face. "Don't cover your face," said granny. "Are you really too sleepy?" Swami uncovered his face little and whispered, "Please, please, granny, don't talk to me and don't let anyone disturb me. Even the house is on fire, I shall sleep. I shall perhaps die if I don't sleep at once. It means let me sleep today, don't disturb me." Then he turned over and curled under the blanket. He started snoring but soon found his blanket pulled away. Father was standing over him. He was acting that he was sleeping, but his father was before him and pulled away the blanket. "I am here. Come and sleep in my office." "Get up, Swami. Get up, Swami," said father for the third time, and Swami got up. Father rolled up his bed, took it under his arm and said, "Come with me." Okay. Swami looked at granny, hesitated at a moment, and then followed his father into the office room. "Let me sleep in the hall, father," Swami pleaded. "Your office room is very dusty and there may be scorpions behind books." It means he is making a lame excuse that there may be a scorpion, so let me sleep. Let me sleep in the hall. "There are no scorpion, boy. You can sleep on the bench if you like. Can I have a lamp burning in the room?" "Kya main lamp jala sakta hoon?" "No, you must learn to be brave. You must not be afraid of darkness. It is only a question of habit. Will you at least leave the door open?" Swami said very humbly. "You are habituated to sit with your granny. That's why you are asking for a lamp. Don't be habituated. It is the matter of your habit. You are habituated." "All right," said father, "but promise you won't roll up your bed and go your granny's side at night. If you do it, I will tell your teacher and make you the laughing stock of the whole school. It means if you in the middle of the night go to the granny's side, then I will tell all the things to before your classmates. And it will be a laughing stock for you and it will be laughing stock among your school friends." Okay. Swami felt pain and anger. He didn't like the cruelty his father was showing. He cursed the newspaper that had printed the tiger's story. He wished that the tigers had not spared the boa. The night advanced and the silence in the house deepened. Swami's heart began to fear beat faster. He remembered all the stories of devils and ghosts he had heard. He was almost faint with fear. He was thinking if the tiger ate the boa, that would be very useful for me. And that's due to the bravery of that shown by that boy, my father is teaching me a lesson of bravery. And that's why I am in such condition. And he was not sleeping the night, he was awaking whole night. Swami hurriedly got up and spread his bed under the bench and crouched there. It seemed to be a much safer place. He shut his eyes tight and encased himself in his blanket. Unknown to himself, Swami felt asleep. In his sleep, he had a terrible dream. It means after having all the trouble, he had a sleep in the night. Okay? A tiger was chasing him. Swami tried hard to escape, but his feet would not move. He tried to open his eyes, but his eyelids would not open. He groaned in despair. It means he wants to open his eyes, but due to fear, he is not opening his eye. Okay? At last, using his utmost effort, he opened his eyes. He put his hand out to feel his granny's presence. As was his habit, but he only touched the wooden leg of the bench. At once his lovely state came back to him. He shook in fear and closed his eyes. He heard a little rustling noise in the room. It means as he was habituated to turn his hand besides his granny, and now he turned his hands, but he found the leg of the table, not the presence of his granny. What can this be? Thought Swami, and slowly opened his eyes. Something was moving in the darkness. Swami lay gazing at in the horror. He was certain that his end had come. It means he thinking what is moving, and he thinks that it may be the ghost, and he thinks that his end has come. The devil would soon pull him out and tear him into pieces. So what is the use of waiting? Swami thought. As it came nearer, Swami crawled out from under the bench, and at once he clutched his leg and dug his teeth in. It means now he thought, I couldn't do anything. I have to face it. And after all the hesitations, Swami faced and tear him into pieces. As it came nearer, dug his teeth in. There was a painful cry, oh, something has bitten me. There was a heavy tumbling and falling amidst furniture. Everyone in the house was awakened by the loud noise. In a moment, father and a servant came running with a light. And when he teeth in, his father, servant came in. What's happened? And what is the sound of this? Both of them fell on the burglar, who lay amidst the furniture with a bleeding knee. Burglar means he was a criminal, unknowingly entered into his house, and Swami teeth in, okay, and faced him. The next day was a day of congratulations for Swami. His classmates looked at him with respect. His teacher patted his back for his courage and bravery. The headmaster said that he was a true scout. Swami had bitten into the knee of notorious house's breaker, and the police were grateful to him. It means after the bravery shown by Swami, the criminal had been caught, and police gave a lot of thanks to Swami. And all there is a praise only for Swami, because Swami has done a great job and shown his bravery. When father returned home from the club that night, he asked, where is the boy? Where is the boy? He is asleep so early, he didn't have a wink of sleep the whole of last night, said Swami's mother. Where is he sleeping? His mother said he is sleeping because he don't have a wink of sleep last night. That's why he is sleeping early. In his usual place, it means beside his granny. Sleeping beside his granny again, father exclaimed, that is why he wanted to sleep before I return home, clever boy. And that's why he wants to sleep before I enter the house. Let him sleep where he likes, mother said angrily. You need not risk his life again. All right, pamper him and spoil him as much as you like, father murmured as he walked away to his room. His mother said, let him sleep, don't say anything. And his father said, okay, spoil him, I don't like it. Whatever you like, pamper means spoil. If you want to spoil the life of your child, it's your choice. Swami was following the whole conversation from under the blanket. He felt a great relief to hear his father giving him up. And after, Swami felt great relief. Okay. Now we will see what we have learned from this chapter. We have learned from this chapter, if we want to have the favor of luck, then we must have to brave to assess it. Assessment, use it. And that's why it has said, fortune favors the brave only. Okay, my dear friends, thank you for joining the class. Let's have a discussion of the questions through the comment sections, and you must have to attempt all the questions of this chapter. Thank you. Take care.